Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In today's session, let's see some of the tips and tricks which can be used in Python programming language. These tricks come in handy while doing the coding or while attending an interview on Python. So let's quickly go through some of the tips which we can use in the Python programming language. So firstly, we all have heard about dictionaries. And what is the easy method of creating a dictionary in Python programming language? It is with the help of dictionary comprehension. Tip number 7. Creating a dictionary with the help of dictionary comprehension. Creating a dictionary with the help of dictionary comprehension. So, how can we create a dictionary with the help of dictionary comprehension in just a single line of code? So, suppose if I want to have a key value equal to 1 and value equal to the square of the key value, that is 1 into 1. So that if I want to have a dictionary for a range of numbers, then I can go for a dictionary comprehension. So dict1 is the dictionary which I am creating. And I am creating it with the help of x colon x into x for x in range 6. So within curly braces, I have to specify the key value, that is x, and the value I have to separate it by colon, and the value is x into x, that is the square of this particular value for x. So what are the values of x? In range 0 to 5, it won't consider 6, it will consider 0 to 5. So if we want to create a dictionary with a range of numbers for a particular value of x, and we have a formula for calculating the value of then we can go in for the dictionary comprehension. So when I give this particular statement, and then if I say print dict1, then my output would be in the dictionary format. Initially x will be 0, 0 colon 0, x into x is 0 into 0 is 0. Then x becomes 1. 1 into 1 is 1. X becomes 2. 2 into 2 is 4. X becomes 3. 3 into 3 is 9. X becomes 4. 4 into 4 is 16. Then 5 colon 25. So it has created a dictionary with just a single line of code with the help of dictionary comprehension. So, an easy and a simple way of creating a dictionary is by using dictionary comprehension. So, after covering this particular tip, let's go on to the next one. Suppose, tip number 8, suppose we have a for loop. So, it is ranging from 1 to 5. Or 50 to 55. It is ranging from 50 to 55. So I want an index value. Value is 50. And my index value should be 0. And 51 it should show 1. 52 it should show 2. 53 it should show 3. So I want the index value as well as the values. That is 50, 51, 52, 53. So how do I get this index value and the value? So, the easy method of getting this is with the help of enumerate. Enumeration. So, now let's see how it works. Suppose I am having my LSD1 is equal to 100, 200 and 300. Then let me say for, I'll give it should be in a loop. We have to find the index value for the elements in the loop. So for I comma value in enumerate, then I have to pass my list 1 as a parameter to it. So when it is iterating through this particular list 1, I want to get the index value as well as this particular value. So when I get this statement, and then if I say print I comma value, so what does it print? The first value will be at the 0th index. So it will print I will be 0, value will be 100. The second value, I value, is 1 and 200 is the value. Third I is 2 and 300 is the value. So when we are passing through a loop like LST1, if we want to get the index value as well within the for loop, then we can use the enumerate statement, pass the iterable as a parameter to it, and then we can get the index value as well as the value in the iterable. So this is a simple way of getting the index value while we are iterating through an iterable. Now I don't want my index to start with 0. So I want to make it start with 1. So in that case, I can just give LST1 comma 1. That is, the start index is 1. So when I give this particular statement, my index does not start with 0. It will start with 1, 2 and then 3. So we can give any value. 40 if I give, it will start from 40, 41, 42. So simple way of getting the index value while looping through a iterable is by using the enumerate function. So this was tip number 8. So it comes very handy while doing the coding. And then to remove duplicate elements from a list, remove duplicate elements from a list. So if we have a list can hold duplicate values, and suppose I have my LST1 equal to, which is a list which is having 10, 10, 10, 20, 30, 20, 30. So it is having the duplicate values. Now what is the simple way of removing the duplicates from the list? I can say LST2, a new list, is equal to set of LST1. If I give this particular statement, the set removes duplicates. Set, as we have seen in the set data type, it removes duplicates, and so it gives only 10, 20, 30, but it will be in the set format. So if I have to give list to this, then the output will be in the list format. Now if I say print LST2, print LST2, that is this particular list, then it will print without duplicates. It will print 10, 20 and then 30. So the duplicates have been removed by using the set function. If I give set of LST1, it will remove the duplicates. Then again I want my output to be in the list format, so I have to specify it as list. So we get it in the list format, the items without any repetitions. So, 9th one would be 7, 8, 9. The 9th tip would be how to create a dictionary with two lists. Create a dictionary with two lists. So for this, let me have my two lists, LST 1 equal to 1, 2, 3. Let me have my another list, list 2, which is equal to Ram, Sham, and then Sam. So these are my two lists. With these two lists, I want to create a dictionary. What is the easy method? So let me say LST3. Sorry, I have to create a dictionary. So let me say dict1 is equal to dict zip. We have to use zip for this particular scenario. And I have to specify the two lists which are to use to create a dictionary. So the two lists are LST1, LST2. I have to pass it to the zip function and then the dict so that we create a dictionary. So now if I say print dictionary, print dict1, if I give this particular statement, then my dictionary gets created with 1 colon Ram, comma, 2 colon Sham, and then 3 colon Sam. So my dictionary items get created in this particular manner. So we have to give zip of that zip function, include the two list and then the dictionary. So dict one will be created. So this is the simple way of creating a dictionary with two lists. And now, tip number 10. We all have seen print statement. So today, let's see advanced print statements. Advanced print statement. So the print statement, suppose we have print 10, print 20, and then print 30. Then after the first print, the cursor will come to the new line to print 20. So my output would be 10, 20, 30. So when it encounters the second print, the cursor will be in the new line and it will print the value in the new line. Again, when it encounters another print, it will print it in the new line. So I don't want this to happen. I want to get it in the horizontal way, that is 20, that is 30. So how will I do it? This can be achieved with advanced print parameters. So for this, let me say print 10, comma, end equal to, comma. So when I give end, the cursor won't come to the new line after the first print. It will continue with the same line with the comma symbol. So it will give a comma. And when I write my second print statement, 20. So it won't write it in a new line, but it will continue in the same line. When I give end equal to whatever value is there, that value gets printed over here within the end parameter and it will continue in the same line. So to get 30, I have to say print 30 end equal to comma. So next time when it encounters another print statement, it will give comma and write the new value. So friends, the advanced print statement, we are having a parameter called end parameter which allows us to print in the same line without moving it into the consecutive or the new line. And tip number 11 is frozen set. frozen set. So what does frozen set do? Suppose we have a list. List is mutable. So at any point of time, I do not want my list parameters to be changed. So I want to make it immutable. So if I have my list equal to 10, 20, 30, 40. Now if I say list 2 is equal to frozen set of list 1. Now if I say LST2 of 0 is equal to 50, I am changing my LST2, the 0th index, that is the 10th value, to 50. Then it will say in frozen set item assignment is not possible. Is not possible. So when we give frozen set of list 1, then I cannot modify the contents of the list. Only LST1 I can modify. Since I given LST2 as frozen set of list 1, and then when I am changing LST2 contents, it gives an error telling frozen set item assignment is not possible. So these were some simple tips which come in handy during coding and also while attending the interview. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye-bye.